From Alaska Public Media, this is State of Art. Welcome to the weekend and to State of Art, your weekly dose of Anchorage arts and culture. I'm Ammon Swenson. Anchorage Opera returns with Carmen. Performances are May 5th through the 7th. Friday and Saturday's shows are at 8 p.m. and Sundays is at 4 p.m. in the Discovery Theater at the Alaska Center for the Performing Arts. Show leads Audrey Babcock, who plays Carmen, and Ben Werley, who plays Don Jose, joined me in the studio recently and explained why this opera is considered one of the best.
Well, I don't think the music hurts. The music is some of the catchiest and most recognizable music that has ever been written for opera, and just something about the way George Bizet, the composer, captured these human emotions makes it a very visceral experience, especially the end of the show.
Our maestro, Maestro Damaris, he said once in an interview, because he and I have done this show together before, and I thought it was the best line ever, so I'm just going to borrow it. Mm-hmm. He said it's the best musical ever written. And it's true. I mean, it's grand opera in that old sense of it's got a ballet, it's got a chorus, it's got a children's chorus, it's got all the singers and the principals in it, the way it works between, you know, duet, aria, quintet. You know, it's formulaic in that way. It's the biggest kind of opera that we do. But it's also a verismo opera, which means it's real. It's talking about real emotions and passion and betrayal and
jealousy.
Jealousy is primal, and this primal animal, like hollering in the forest, you know, kind of excising of passion and interpersonal issues on a very large scale. So I think that mixed with the fact that when Georges Bizet wrote this, it was panned. People hated it because there was a female character who was expressing her freedom.
Could you maybe talk about her a little bit more and then maybe describe your approach to the role and maybe kind of any relationships that you formed with the character?
She's an alter ego that I can like put on her clothes and I just go there, right? I've studied her for so long. She's very familiar to me and I love her. There's a power structure within the Romani, the gypsy culture, which is where this piece lies. It lies in Seville, but it's a gypsy culture. We have to be very careful now about how we deal with these cultures and how we relate to them as actors who are not. But in this society that we're creating on the stage, she is the ringleader. The gentlemen think they have the power, but she's the one where everything revolves around her. And she knows that. And she knows how to use that power to keep her and everyone in her band alive and fed. And really, she's a caretaker.
Maybe a woman ahead of her time.
Yes, she's very much ahead of her time. She also she doesn't need anybody to do anything for her. She's got it. And she'll convince people or not to help her. And if they don't, she's got it all under control anyway.
It sounds maybe, even though it was from, the 1800s, it's still relevant today.
It's 100% relevant today.
Yeah. Well, how about you, Ben? Same to you.
Oh, absolutely. So José starts out, he's kind of like almost a farm boy. He got into a little bit of trouble in the past and has run away to sort of start anew, but he ends up meeting Carmen and getting swept up in her way of life, and things don't exactly go well for him. And he, probably more than Carmen, has the biggest change over the course of the show, starting out of this fresh-faced soldier. He doesn't have a bit of a past, but by the end of the show, he's almost unrecognizable. So it's a really fun challenge to play that arc and still be able to sing at the end of the night, too.
I mean, do you kind of have to portray that arc in song as well?
Oh, absolutely. A lot of it is in the music that Bizet wrote, so a lot of the choices I don't have to make. Bizet made them for me, and I just have to listen to what is in the score and the emotion that is in the underlying music that does almost most of the acting for me. I just have to be in the right place and have the right expression on my face sometimes.
Totally. That's got to make it nice.
Yeah.
Well, Audrey, let's talk about the fact that you're also the choreographer for the show. You know, what's it like doubling up on responsibilities like that? And, you know, what's the experience like in general, I guess?
Well, when I first took on Carmen for the first time, I started studying flamenco back in 2001. I am a full-time student of flamenco. I will never be a professional in any way. But this is one show that I've done so many times, and this is and I've embodied her to such an extent that this is something I really enjoy doing, especially when there isn't a professional flamenco troupe in town that can take this on. And it's a beautiful experience to share my experience with the community here. And the chorus has been amazing to work with. And they're all so eager to be there and learn the body language. And part of what we do as singer actors is we embody these characters. And this character has a very particular embodiment in that her body works in this very visceral, organic way, and she has to dance and sing and fight. There's a lot of fighting.
There's a lot of fighting in the show.
There's a lot of fighting, and this Spanish/gypsy style of knife work, sword work, flamenco body language, the way that the flamencos talk to each other on the stage, all intertwined, and it's all from this gypsy Romani culture where things are expressed without words. And it's just a really beautiful thing to embody and to share with the Anchorage community.
How are you liking the choreography, Ben?
Luckily, there's not too much for me. I just get to enjoy it. Audrey, there's a number near the beginning of Act Two where Carmen has castanets and is dancing for Don Jose. And I'm in awe watching Audrey just jump into it. She flipped the light switch in rehearsal, and all of a sudden it was Carmen standing there, and it was incredible. Mm-hmm. And to be able to sing and play the castanets and dance at the same time, I was very impressed.
You've got the best seat in the house.
I do.
That was Audrey Babcock and Ben Werley, the leads of Anchorage Opera's upcoming production of Carmen. Shows are May 5th through the 7th in the Discovery Theater at the Alaska Center for the Performing Arts.